everybody. I'm your host, Alex Margulies, and welcome back to the Miracle Insider Show. I can't believe this is already our 7th episode. The Miracle just wrapped up the first half of the season, and after going neck and neck with the St. Lucie Mets, unfortunately, they finished in second. Let's check out the final standings after the first 70 games. First, in the South Division, St. Lucie won their last 4 in a row to beat out the Miracle by 4 games. Overall, it was a rough half for the entire division, except for the Mets. In the North, Daytona won by a wide margin with their impressive 47-23 record, one of the best in the entire minor leagues. It looks like the second half will be tightly contested, with Clearwater, Dunedin, and Tampa playing very well to finish up the first half. The good news is for the Miracle, with the second half starting, there's another chance of making the playoffs. We talked to some of the players about starting this new season.
That's the good part about this league is that the second half is a whole new beginning for us, and we're looking forward to coming out and playing hard and, you know, hopefully getting that playoff spot.
Throw the stats out the window. We're starting over clean second half. You know, just play hard every day. Stats are coming alive, so I think we're rolling now.
One of the hottest pitchers right now in the Twins organization is Miracle right-hander Tom Stuifbergen. It's time to dig up some dirt on the Dutch right-hander. Here is Bryce Zimmerman.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back into another segment of In the Dirt. I'm Bryce Zimmerman, joined by Miracle pitcher, native of the Netherlands, Tom Stuifbergen. Thanks for being here.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Are you ready?
I'm ready.
He's as ready as he'll ever get. And being from the Netherlands, you pitched in the World Baseball Classic. So the very first question, it's going to be a tough one. Would you rather pitch another World Baseball Classic game or go see a World Cup final with Holland as the team?
That's a very tough one, but I choose my own sport over soccer, I guess. So I'd pitch in another World Baseball Classic.
Wow. Is he really Dutch?
I am.
Your older brother, Nick, pitched with you in the World Baseball Classic, and he's another guy that can throw the ball pretty hard. Who's got the better stuff out of you two?
I got to be arrogant about that. I go with myself because, I mean, he never played pro, but he started pitching when he was only 21. So he never got the chance to play pro, so I go with myself.
All right, well, now here's the twist. Which one of you two is a better hitter?
I go with myself again because he's got one lazy eye, so he doesn't see depth very well, so it's tough for him to hit, so I got that one pretty easy.
Wow, so you're 2-for-2 over your brother.
Yeah.
That's tough. That's
hopefully
tough love.
Hopefully he doesn't see this.
All right, you've pitched all over the world, having been in the World Baseball Classic, a lot of difficult places to play. What's the best atmosphere worldwide?
I think I go with Chinese Taipei. I played there in 06 and last offseason. Whenever you play against Taiwan itself, they're like 15,000 Asian fans with like all those horns and stuff, and they sing and do stuff. It's really, really good to play in that atmosphere.
How difficult is it with the horns to pitch and concentrate?
They all actually go forward a little bit and they hit it like on their chair, like to make a rhythm, and it's pretty funny. Like whenever you're on the mound, you're like in a tunnel, so you don't have any clue, but when you're out, you're like, oh my, it's pretty cool.
All right, keeping with the Dutch theme, Holland has excellent chocolate, some of the best in the world. For our fans out there that want some Dutch chocolate, what's the brand?
It's not really the brand. I'd say if you want to have some real good Dutch chocolate, you go into like those little stores in Amsterdam that make their own chocolate. Like whenever you walk past it, you're like, wow, that smells amazing. And those, it's really, really expensive, but it's called Puccini. That's one of the big stores. And that's probably the best chocolate there is.
Amsterdam, a city that has everything.
They say so.
All right, final question. Famke Janssen, who is part Dutch, was in the X-Men movies, and she was Jean Grey. She had phenomenal superpowers, so I gotta ask Tom Stuifbergen, what would your superpower be?
I'd probably go with flying. I mean, I was never a fast guy, so maybe the wings get me fast, so
all right.
I go with that.
So he likes to fly, Chinese Taipei, the toughest place to pitch, and pretty much any Dutch chocolate will do.
Exactly.
All right, that's Tom Stuifbergen. I'm Bryce Zimmerman.
I got my master's in statistics at Temple University in Philadelphia. I'm a numbers guy. For me, it's 6-4-3. I love writing that down in the scorecard, and I got them all at home. I'm a stats guy, and that's why I'm here, to keep track of everything that goes on and let everybody else know.
This past week, the Miracle held their first of 3 baseball camps for the Little Sluggers, and it had a little bit of everything.
Oh, you know, I had a blast today, you know, with the kids. You know, it was hot outside, but the kids came and they just had fun. And I actually was teaching them how to hit off the tee, you know, hit everything back up the middle. And it was just a lot of fun because we split up into teams and had good competition between the kids. And it was just a lot of fun altogether.
What you're trying to do, especially with young kids, it's more just making the game fun, you know, and keeping their interest in it and you know, some fundamentals here and there. But as long as they're having fun and they're interested in the game, that's all that really matters. They kind of supply the energy, you know. They get you pumped up and get you going too. And I know a lot of them were telling us, hey, we're going to come watch you guys play tonight and all that. So that's pretty fun, you know. And they'll sit up there, holler and scream, and it'll be good to see them.
There's still plenty of time to sign up for the final two baseball camps this year, with ages 9 through 12 taking place on the 13th to the 15th, and our advanced camp for players 13 and up taking place on July 26th. For more information, call Joy Donahue in the Miracle offices at 239-768-4210. That's a wrap on today's show. Don't forget you can follow the Miracle on the road by listening to the broadcasts on miraclebaseball.com or by downloading the Miracle app, which is available both on the iPhone and the Android. It is 100% free. That's it for the Miracle Insider Show this week. I'm your host, Alex Margulies. We'll see you next time.